All right, y'all, what's up? Wait a minute. It's your boy Bo Dunn for Bo Dunn Wins. Today is Sunday, November 21st, 2021. This video, I'm just going to let y'all know a little bit about me, who I am, when I started my business, you know, just things to kind of introduce myself. Also, I'm going to be letting y'all know what kind of strategies and, you know, things I use to come up with my picks. And also, I'm going to let y'all know how I became a handicapper and the reason why I do it. So we got a lot to discuss. If you're new to the channel, make sure you subscribe. Also, make sure you turn that bell on, so every time I put out a new video, you'll get that alert. You'll be in the loop. Also, make sure you hit them like buttons, man. Trying to get the likes up. Right now, I think we at 665 subs. So trying to get to 1,000 and beyond, because I do want to start going live with y'all, man. You know what I'm saying? And, you know, so the channel can get a little more up ranked on YouTube. So yeah, man, I got my video stuff in. I got my camera and got my light, man. So starting tomorrow on Monday, you know what I'm saying, I'm start doing visual videos every day. And the time I'm trying to put them out, just say when games come on later on, like at 6, I'm gonna try to put the video out at least before 2-3 p.m. Central, you know, my time. And on Saturdays and Sundays, we got early games, or any day we got early games on, I'm gonna put the video out, you know, maybe like 3 hours before the games come on, you know what I'm saying? Because we're gonna discuss why, you know, I do a bit longer than put my plays out than most people. But yeah, man, it's your boy Bo Dunn, you know what I'm saying? I started professionally handicapping in 2014. So, going on 7-8 years right now. And, the reason why I started betting on sports is because I was, you know, used to be parlaying every day, me and my cousin, Jeremy. And, we, you know, every day, man, we try and do everything we can do, you know, to, you know, win these tickets, man, winning parlays and, you know, doing that process, you know, that's why I got this term where I say wins and lessons. You know, a lot of people say wins and losses. I call it wins and lessons because every time we lost a ticket, we always learn. You know what I'm saying? We seen a pattern where if we put a 3 pick in, it would go 2-1. You know what I'm saying? We put a 5 pick in, it would go 4-1. You know, we always lost one game, you know, almost 90% of the time. And we did this for like a year or so. You know, one day, man, the light bulb just clicked on. I said, man, you know what? Because what happened was I had put a 10 pick in, and one game cost me a lot of money. And so I said, man, I was like 9 games, because, you know, the little rule was if you at least you win 9, they get you 100. So I said, you know, they know that's hard to hit 9 out of 10 play. That's why they give you that. So that kind of made that light bulb come on. Say, man, I left 9 winners on the board. You know, if I would have put $100 on each one of those games, if I had $1,000, and I said, if I would have put $100 on each game, you know, I would have had a nice little profit, you know what I'm saying? Almost $1,000 profit, you know, instead of losing. So that's when I kind of learned that It's more wiser to bet straight games instead of betting parlays, especially if you want to, you know, be successful with this. And, yeah, man, so that's when me and my cousin started saying that we're going to make our own YouTube channel. We're going to get our own website, you know, like the ones we've been seeing on YouTube, you know, sports book review, docs, you know, the ones that be on YouTube all the time. So I was like, look, man, we can get our own channel, whatever. And so, around about 2018, you know, that's when I decided, man, go on, got the camera, everything. I started doing my channel. And, yeah, man, after that, you know, started getting some views and started learning the lingo, you know, juice, what the juice is, and spread, you know what I'm saying? I just started getting more lingo with it. That's when I come on videos. But yeah, man, I've been doing this every day straight for like the last 3 years, man. I know for sure on YouTube. And I learned a lot, man. And I want to share, you know, what I went through to get to this point. And so now, instead of me looking at this as gambling, I look at it as an investment, just like stock, you know. And so first thing I wanted to let y'all know is that if you ever hire me to be your sports consultant, you know what I'm saying? I am a personal person. So I would give y'all a number. It's one of my work numbers where you can hit me up personally. You see what I'm saying? Like, a lot of times my people, they'll call and ask me, hey man, my book only got it as 5. You know what I'm saying? You do I want to take it? So I'll tell them my advice about it. You know what I'm saying? Because sometimes, you know, it happens so fast. So I always give them the opportunity to ask me if I'll take it or not. For example, like today, when the Ravens and Bears, you know, it was up in the air if Lamar Jackson gonna play. So right around maybe like an hour before the game come on, maybe later, they put a notification out that he wasn't playing. So the line went all the way down from 5 to like -1. So I immediately got a text from my people asking me, what's up? I told them, even though the Ravens wanted to win it, I told them no play. You see what I'm saying? Because when I made the pick, it was predicated on Lamar Jackson playing. So, yeah, things like that, man. So I'm a personal person when it comes to what I do for people. Also, number two, I'm going to show y'all how I came up with my bankroll and my unit amount. And how I normally bet, you know what I'm saying, when it comes to placing wages. So number two, we started with the bankroll. So a bankroll is what I became to learn is the money you have set to the side that you use solely for betting on games with, you know what I'm saying? It's not going to affect your bottom line, such as your rent, car note, food, you know what I'm saying? This is something that you done saved up to where you just gonna specifically bet on sports with. That's what your bankroll is. So I started out with $1,000. So you can't start out with some lower 500, whatever you got, man. If you got 100, whatever you got, you know what I'm saying? Your bankroll is whatever you got saved up. You know what I'm saying? If it's small, we'll just have to build it up. But once you get that bankroll put to the side, you know what I'm saying, your book or whatever you got. You got $500 in the book, like $1,000 like me. And then, so the way you come up with, the way I came up with my unit amount, that's what I seen a lot of people doing, was like 5% of your bankroll. You know what I'm saying? And that's like being aggressive when you first starting out because, you know, your bankroll is kind of small. But if you want to build it up a little bit, I recommend 5%. Like your bankroll. So when I started out, I had $1,000. So I was betting $50 a game. Now that I have my unit amount, you know what I'm saying? Use 5%, whatever you got. That's your unit. And when I first started out, I was putting like, you know, 7 units on this game, 5 and whatever. So I learned pretty fast that that was not a good way to do it. I see a lot of people doing it though. You know what I'm saying? So if it worked for some people, it just didn't work for me. Because I would put out normally 3 picks a day. And one time I put out a seven unit top play. And then I had my other play just 1 unit a piece. So I had $900 in play. So I hit the 2 $100 picks. So I won $200, but I lost the 7. So I went down $500 that day. Now, if I would have put the 300, same amount on each game, I would have had a profit about $90. So that's why I recommend all the people I work with to put 1 unit on each play. And I always do an uneven amount, like 3 plays, 5 plays, because that way, you know, you go 2-1, 3-2. So long as you have more winners than losers, you're going to show a profit that day. And that's really what you're trying to do, man, in the long run. You know what I'm saying? It's not no fast money. It's not nothing that's going to flip over in one day. But I guarantee you, if you start with $1,000, man, and you work with me, you're going to turn that $1,000 to about at least $5,000 to $10,000 in a year. Now, I know that don't seem like a lot of money, but you got to look at this as an investment, like you're investing in some stock. You know what I'm saying? If you put $10,000 in a portfolio, you know, you're going to check it every 3 months. Every quarter, they're going to let you see your statement. And you know, just realistically that $1,000 not going to turn to no 100 grand unless you just done got your major stock. You know what I'm saying? Which it can happen. You know, I done been on hot streak before, man, where I done won, you know, 10 G's in a week. So it can happen. But just realistically, man, we got to look at this like a business. You know what I'm saying? We know if you start a business from scratch and you just open it today, you know you got to self-maintain that business for at least 5 years. You're going to be paying in. You're not going to be reckoning to see no profit. But if you can last, you know what I'm saying, stay down, stay focused and disciplined, then that business is going to start flourishing. You know, a lot of people don't make it them 5 years because they don't have patience. They don't have focus. So that's one of the things that I let my people know, man. It's a grind. You know, just be ready for the long game. So, yeah, man. So that's how you start your bankroll. You know, get you some money set to the side that you're going to use to spend on sports. Then use 5% of that as your unit and flat bet every, you know, same amount of units on each play and eat uneven play 3 to 5 plays a day. And on the weekends, you know, we might do 7 or something like that just because there's more games on the weekend. But yeah, but that's how you do that. That's number two. Number three is that the how I bet, you know what I'm saying? Like I am a 90 to 95%, almost 100% straight better. You know what I'm saying? I do straight plays and I'm not going to sit here and lie that I don't do teasers and parlays. I do, but I rarely send out teasing parlays to my clients. Now, if I see something that makes sense, I will put out a 2-team parlay or a 2-team teaser. I do those all the time. So if it makes sense and I think it's a top play, you know, caliber thing, so I will send that to my people. And I do have some people that ask me, hey, man, you know, what's your long shot parlay or whatever day? If I got some, I'll send it to them, but I'll let them know. You know, just bet your quarter unit on that. You know what I'm saying? So if you bet 100 play, just put 25 on it. You know, just like that. But yeah, man, 90% of my bets are straight. You know what I'm saying? I put the same amount each play. You know, I seen something. I read an article that the University of Las Vegas made, UNLV, they wrote. And they said that they did a research on the sports books. And they had something what they call a hold. So the bookmakers would have a 70% hold on people that did parlays and teasers. You know what I'm saying? Meaning that they keep 70% of the money on all type of wagers. So if they go in there and put in $10,000 with the bets and on parlays and teasers, that mean a bookmaker gonna keep $7,000 and only pay all three. So that's why they call it sucker bet. That's why they love people to come in there and parlay. And I was one of them for a long time, but no. You know what I'm saying? So I recommend my people, you know, just be smart on that, man. You know what I'm saying? I give them the game, you know, 70% hold on parlay. So we trying to get on the other side, which is, it said if the people that come in there and do straight wagers, it's the total opposite. It's 70% for the better, 30% for the book. That's why sports book don't like to see people coming in and putting in straight bets, because they know they done figured out what's happening. You know what I'm saying? They done put themselves in the best position to win, and the sports book don't like people that win. So we're gonna be on that side called just us against the books. But yeah, man, third thing is I normally bet games straight. All right, man, but as far as that go, man, you know, the way I cap the games, I'm a little bit old school. This number four, I wear a cap. I'm a little bit old school. You see what I'm saying? I take my time with it. I know a lot of people like getting them early lines, you know, that's kind of, correlated with being a sharp. You know what I'm saying? Sharp, they say the sharp are the wise guys. You know, they get them lines early. And, I've seen that to be beneficial. You see what I'm saying? But with me being blind, you know what I'm saying? It just take me a little bit longer. You know what I'm saying? To gather the information. You know what I'm saying? I don't have a supercomputer. I don't have a whole team of nerdy guys. You know what I'm saying? Smart ass people. you know, crunching these numbers for me. I got to do it myself. So that's why my videos come out a little bit later, because I just ain't trying to get y'all know any kind of play just for a video content sake. You know what I'm saying? The picks I get out on the channel is the same picks I'm putting my money on. Y'all can see when I put a ticket down there. You know what I'm saying? Like, I bet $300, $330 on the Seahawks today, and I lost. You know what I'm saying? So, yeah, every pick I put out on the channel, I'm putting my own money on it. And that's why I take, you know, a little bit longer. So, just trying to get y'all the best content, best free pick possible, because I know most of the people that watch my channels, that's the only play they get from me. You know what I'm saying? So, I do want to give them a winner, because I really appreciate y'all's time and for checking in. It's really important to me. So I try to bring y'all a nice play, man. Try to put some money in your pocket just for joining. But yeah, man. So like I said, on normal days, I try to get the video out at least, you know, by 12. And then I try to have the whole card for the day ready to go. You know what I'm saying? About 3. On the days where the games come on the 6th. Now on the weekends, I try to get that card out, you know, a little bit earlier, you know, just for the sake of giving y'all time to put the bait in. But yeah, I like to wait till the line kind of settle to kind of see where the line moving. That I don't know, for me, that's where I get my better success at. You know what I'm saying? When I see that line, just like today, when that Baltimore game went down to -1, you know what I'm saying? So, a lot of times you don't have the information that you need, especially with this, with the COVID era. You know, you don't know what's going to happen on the day of that game. So I like to wait to get the most information possible to make the most sound decision. So yeah, man, I know this video pretty long, but I just want to kind of put out an evergreen video, man, that can be there forever. So I'm going to label it, you know, an introduction to myself, just because I want to let people know who they're working with, man. I'm a real dude. I lost my sight in 2005. So, sports betting has gave me a lane, man, for financial freedom. You know what I'm saying? When I went blind, I was like, what am I going to do for work? You know, how am I going to make money to support my kids, my family? And, yeah, man, sports betting, my love for this has, you know, provided for me and my family, man. So it done been a blessing to me. I want to be a blessing to y'all. So if y'all want to rock with my services, man, bodunnwin.net. The link will always be on top of the comments. We're still working on the website, man, but it's functional, where you can buy a pack and win some money with your boy, man. So make sure to share this video. Subscribe to the channel if you're new. Turn that bell on. Also, make sure to check me out on Pick Mother. You can see my results. And yeah, man, it's your boy Bo Dunn, man. AKA the Blind Capper, represent BC Nation, checking in for bodunnwin.net. From now on, man, you can follow me on Twitter. That's the only place I'm going to be, because it's kind of take a lot more time and to try to post on all them other places. So I'm a master Twitter. So if y'all want to follow me and get in touch with me on social media, where I'm putting my, you know, free plays and stuff like that, man, y'all can see that on Twitter at GamblerJunkie1. That link going to be in the description. All right, man, you can check this video out on YouTube. You also can grab it on my podcast, man. I'm on Apple Podcasts, on Bo Dunn Wins. You know, anywhere you get your podcast at, man, Google, all that, man. So if you don't get it on YouTube, man, you can listen to it over on podcast as well, man. But yeah, man, appreciate y'all for joining. You know what I'm saying? Give me your time, man. It's your boy Bo Dunn. Let's win a lot of money. This is not gambling. This is a sports investment. It's like the stock. So let's be right with this. Be ready for the long game. And I hope this video, you know, get y'all some, value, man. So, all right, man. I'll see y'all on the next one. Peace.